Welcome to Vinyl Treasures. I'm your host, Johnny G, John Galindo, coming to you live each and every Saturday, only here on YouTube. Want to welcome you to the 50s, early 60s edition this February, it's February 4th, 2023. It's my father's birthday today. He's 92. We were downstairs. I had some siblings here today, so I've been going back and forth, really last-minute scans for the show. Plus, we don't want to get into it here, but want to welcome you to the Vinyl Treasure Show. Those of you tuned in tonight and on YouTube, we'll see how it goes, because I got a lot of records to play tonight, lots of requests. We're probably going to go into the OT, but we opened up tonight with tonight's 50s edition with band leader, drummer, pianist, and sometimes vocalist from Youngstown, Ohio, recorded for Sid Nathan's King record label between the years 1950 and 1958. That was his 16th of 25 on the King label, from July 1953, a song he co-wrote with Red Prysock. Had sort of a Red Prysock sound there, but that was Tiny Bradshaw. Tiny Bradshaw on the King label from July 53. It's called Free For All. But that's our opener tonight. You know, we open up with an opener every Saturday, and I really all my shows, even my soul show too. But anyway, enough of my babbling here. I know a lot of you like that. It was funny. Spence used to coin that. He said he loved that saying. That's my very own saying. But anyway, let's open up now with the vocal portion here. Now, if you listened to Gus Gossert back in the 1970s like I did, you might remember this next song, and it's the debut single for this group out of New Haven, Connecticut, managed by Marty Kugel, as he released this on his Click label, co-written by the group's, he was the group's manager, he co-wrote this. It features Sal Tramouchi on lead. Now, the inspiration for this song, if you don't know it, was due to a New Haven, Connecticut City Council banning Alan Freed from doing his big beat show in New Haven, Connecticut. He said, we don't want any riots here. We don't want this. So that's it. But so it inspired this song. So we open up here the vocal portion from May 58 on the Click label. These are the Nobles. The Nobles with Poor Rock and Roll. The sound of the Nobles to kick off the vocal portion here on tonight's Vinyl Treasure Show. The Nobles with Sal Tramucci or Tramucci on lead there, May 1958, a Marty Klugel's Click record label there. Now, Sal would leave the group to be replaced by Nicky Delano. Now, Nicky Delano had a release on Gone Records, George Goldner's Gone Records. You might know Nicky and the Nobles. School Bells, you remember that? That is Nicky Delano on lead with the Nobles there. And one more release on George Goldner's TG record label as the Timbers. And it featured, I think, Mario Giamo. He became the lead singer then. He was a member of the group all the time, but he became the lead singer. And I think I have that. I have it as the Timbers, and you can also get it as the Nobles on the TG record label. Johnny G, a completist, as you know, as I spin my original vinyl 45s every Saturday right here on YouTube. We'll be joining Oldies and More Radio beginning at midnight tonight, if I could hold out, that is. So let's go with this next tune here. The first time I heard this next tune, as it was a theme song to Ronnie I's, I think it was his R&B party on WNYE, I think. Now, the group is out of Harlem, New York, and according to Louis Silvani, this group initially recorded as the Sparks on the Hull record label back in 1957, but they would change their name to the Lollipops. And I'm featuring the true first press of this, which came out in May of 1958 on Universal International. 6 months later, it was issued on the Holland label. I have it on Universal International. Was lucky to find this one. It's a rare 45. This is from May 58. The Lollipops on Universal International. It's called Believe in Me.
Said to you, dear, is true. darling, my love, dear, I've done all I can.
I have been so lonely, thinking of you only. Why did we have to part? If you will awaken, you won't be mistaken, for you have the key to my heart.
Believe in me.
Why?
There are things I want you to know. Dear, I am not pretending when I say I love you so.
That's a rare 45 there by the Lollipops, May 1958 release. Universal International is the first label. I don't know why they changed it. The same guy put it out on the Holland record label. Believe in Me is the name of the tune. Remember that? That was the Ronnie I theme song on his R&B party. As you know, we count down the music chronologically here on the 50s, early 60s edition. If you're new to the program, please subscribe. Please give me a thumbs up. Because it's really important for YouTube that you give me a thumbs up here. We're trying to get to 1,000 subscribers. That's my main concern. I want to get to 1,000 subscribers, so tell your friends about it. Pass the show around. You get an email if you hit the bell to get notifications. Am I talking pretty good for a pulled molar? My third molar was pulled on Wednesday. Like I said, I'm worried about taking the antibiotics that it doesn't make me sick, but I don't feel so well today, so I hope the antibiotics are not taking me over. Let's just hope not. But we play the music chronologically here on the 50s and early 60s edition, and this is an early side. All requests tonight, I think I have just two or three that I've added to the show, but this is an early side from January 1952, and this is a request for Texas listener Jim Lampley. This group had 21 releases between December of 1950 and September of 1957 for Sid Nathan's Federal record label. Now, Jim requested their fifth release, and it's a cover tune that was recorded first. Actually, this is a cover tune recorded first by the Ink Spots, I think on Decca, back in 1940. But this side features the great Clyde McFatter on leads. This is going out to Jim in Texas, January 52, the Dominoes on Federal, and their rendition of the tune, When the Swallows Come Back to Capistrano.
That's the day promised to come back to me. Yes, to me. When you whispered farewell in Capistrano. Was the day the swallows flew out to the sea.
All the mission bells will ring. The chapel choir will sing the happiness you'll bring. Ooh, we live in my memory.
When the swallows come back to Capistrano. extra love. That's the day I pray that you'll come back to me. That's today I pray you'll come to me.
As January 1952 release for the Dominoes by request for Jim Lampley, When the Swallows Come Back to Capistrano, Sid Nathan's Federal record label, the great sound of Clyde McFatter on lead for that one. And of course, then he would join the, when did he join the Drifters? 1953, I think, the end of that year, possibly. But a great singer there, Clyde McFatter. The Dominoes will return with another request later on in the show here. But let's continue here. Let's move into 1953 with this request for Bob Evans, listening in the state of Ohio. Now, Bob, I know you're watching me. Johnny G on the tablet, and Andy Lamusio, you use the tablet, I think, and Bob was having issues getting into the chat room there, and I've never watched the show on the tablet, so if anybody has any information I could forward to Bob, send me an email at vinyltreasures@aol.com, that he can't see the chat room or can't get into the chat. I know he has to be signed in. I think you have to be signed into YouTube to be able to chat with the chatters there. But anyway, this is a request for Bob Evans, and this group is out of Harlem, New York, initially backing up Fat Man Humphreys and Viola Watkins as the Four Notes, but they met up with George Golner, signed with Rama Records, and the A side of their first release, I think it was the A side, I don't think this would have been the A side, maybe not, was a song called No Help Wanted, which I think I played back on the June 4th, 2020 2022 show for Rick in Philly. But Bob requested the flip side. Now, they are doing background vocals again, backing up Viola Watkins, but the Goldner gave them full credit here. I can't see my copy. So you talk about when Johnny G makes mistakes on buying records. So this was my first copy of this record. I bought it from, I think, Chris Ciccone at probably Springfield, New Jersey. There was a show there in one of the Holiday Inns or Marriott hotels. So I didn't have this record. He had a decent price on it, but it's not in great shape, especially the label. The other side's a little bit more cleaner, but I had a chance to get a mint copy, but I didn't want to pay the four figures at the time because I already had it. Now, you know, later on I started upgrading, but unfortunately not for this one. I've never seen another copy since. It's not that easy to find this record. But anyway, let's give a listen to the Crows. This is for Bob Evans backing up Viola Watkins here, April 1953. Actually, Daryl, you requested the flip side of this back then too, so we're going to send it out to Bob and Daryl. These are the Crows with Viola Watkins. It's called Seven Lonely Days from April 1953.
Thank you.
lying. Oh, 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 there's no use in denying. I cried for you. It was your favorite.
There you go. Whoops. Scratches and all. It doesn't play so bad. But those are the Crows with Viola Watkins there. That were there from April 1953. That's going out to Bob Evans and Daryl Letts in our YouTube chat room. Seven Lonely Days, George Golner's Rama Records. That's just one of the mistakes I learned from. That was one of the records I should have purchased the mint copy. I haven't seen another copy since, but it isn't that bad anyway. Let's stay in 1953 now. Now, on last week's Vinyl Treasure Show, I featured this great group out of Baltimore, Maryland. Was a request for Jim Lampley, their 10th of 11 on Sid Nathan's King record label, by the Swallows. The song was called Trust in Me. That featured Junior Denby on lead. Let's give a listen to their 11th, and this is a request for Gordy Freeman in our YouTube chat room. This is a great tune here. It features Eddie Rich on lead. We go back to November 1953. This is for Gordy, the Swallows on the King label. It's called I'll Be Waiting.
For you.
one who loves you until then I'll be waiting just waiting for you.
That's a great sound of the Swallows there. Eddie Rich and the Swallows by request for Gordy Freeman in our YouTube chat room, November 1953. I'll be waiting. What a great record that is. Eddie Rich, great sound of Eddie Rich there. The Swallows will be returning in a couple records, so stay tuned for that as we stay in 1953. Now, another 45 I played last week on last week's Vinyl Treasure Show was out of Philadelphia, PA, requested by Daniel Kubacki. Came out on Herb Slotkin's Grand record label. It was by the Castells. And I played the B-side. Daniel requested the B-side of their debut single. The song was called Sweetness. It featured Octavius Anthony on lead. This week, Daniel requested the intended A-side. Of course, it's featuring 16-year-old George Grant on lead. Let's go back to October 1953. This is for Daniel in our YouTube chat room, the Castells on the Grand label. It's called My Girl Awaits Me. Me. Jazz by request for Daniel Kubacki there, The Sound of the Castells. George Grant and the Castells, October 1953 release, My Girl Awaits Me. That one there on Herb Slotkin's Grand Record label. I was trying to find my flat blue press that I showed you last week for the flip side. I know it's here. It's not in the back box there of records that I have to file back. But the true first press of this are on the shiny blue label. I think a Big Dave Swinger typed it in the YouTube chat room there. Then comes on the flat blue label. Then finally the thick yellow label. This is a thick label. And I found one out in the wild on the cheap, but it wasn't that clean. This is Norm's copy, Brian. Sounds pretty good. It does. Johnny G here on a Saturday evening spinning original vinyl 45. Let's continue here, and the Swallows return, this time for listener Jim Lampley. We heard their 11th and a final one for Sid Nathan's King Records earlier. Gordy requested that one. It was called I'll Be Waiting with Eddie Rich on lead. Now, Jim requested their 8th release, and this features Junior Denby on lead. The tune written by Henry Glover. We're going to send this one out to Jim. March 1953, The Swallows on the King label. It's called Our Love is Dying.
We put out two hearts together and found how love could be. Ooh, now you see it dying, and no one is crying but me. I don't believe you could be sorry. If so, you'd show some sympathy. Baby, when our love is dying, no one is crying but me. I won't accept your flowers. Don't do favors for my sake. 'Cause in my grief-stricken hours, you won't be there at the wake. There's nothing I can do to save it. You've made it so plain to see. Baby, our love is slowly dying. No one is crying but me.
I can't say we had a twin spin, although we did have a twin spin on the Swallows there. That one there for Jim Lampley. That's their 8th release on the King Record label with the Junior Denby on lead, March 1953. The Swallows with Our Love is Dying. I was contemplating playing this next 45 with a 78 needle because the 78 sounds excellent. I have this, the label Derby Records. It's a black label 78. They're really nice. I have a nice copy. Actually, I searched out the 78 because I was so unsatisfied with the sound of the 45, especially with a 45 needle. It's too much surface noise. It's like a real grainy press, and it just doesn't play well. But I'm gonna go ahead with it because we move it to 1954 with a request for listener Jimmy Amato. This group is out of Brooklyn, New York. It's their debut single. Came out on Larry Newton's Derby Record label, and it features Jimmy McGowan on lead. This is going out to Jimmy Amato from August 54. Give a listen to the Four Fellows. The Four Fellows on the Derby label. The song is called I'll Try.
I tried to pretend I loved it always to you. My heart kept saying never with me. You belong by my side, my side, my side. Oh, but you lied when you broke my heart deep down inside. And you left me with all of a sigh. So I'm saying goodbye. Time that if I kissed you, my heart would melt away. But I don't give a darn if I miss you. So listen to what I have to say, and don't you cry. Wipe the teardrops away from your eyes, 'cause your daddy is saying goodbye. Don't say I didn't try. If I kissed you, my heart would melt away. Well, I don't give a darn if I miss you now. So listen to what I say and don't you cry. Wipe those tears out away from your eyes. Well, your daddy is saying goodbye. Don't say I didn't try.
Yes, I tried.
Yes, I tried. Yes, I tried.
Sis and all, that's by request for Jimmy Amato there, The Sound of the Four Fellows. Jimmy McGowan and the Four Fellows there, August 1954, I Tried on the Derby record label. After this, they would go on, of course, to sign with Glory Records. The flip side I like, too, Bend in the River, I think, is the name of that one. But it plays excellent on the 78, I got to tell you that much. And I do have a mint 78. For you know, there's certain records that I did also want to collect on a 78, not because I wanted duplicates, because they sounded better. That Gaylarks, the Gaylarks on that red label. Somebody help me here. It's the COVID Fog on that Red Wax Gaylarks. What's the label? Somebody type it in the chat room there. You know what I'm talking about. Anyway, Johnny G losing his mind here. Let's stay in Brooklyn, New York. We go back to Sid Nathan's King record label. This is a great record. I picked this up at one of the Allentown shows. Now, it wasn't in great shape, but it plays excellent. You'll give a listen to it. But these are the Strangers, and it's a request for Gordy Freeman in our YouTube chat room. Now, a group signed with King Records in 1953. They went on to have six Timely. There you go. Evan said it on Timely. Timely's the label. The group went on to have six releases on the King record label. Now, Gordy requested their second. It features the lead of Pringle Sims on lead. Let's go back to April 1954. The Sound of the Strangers on the King record label. This is for Gordy. The song is called Blue Flowers.
Here are some flowers, all tied in blue. Please take these flowers, for they belong to the beauty of nature is quite a scene.
with my heart and these flowers. Love will show you what I mean. See the colors blending with the sky. Their beauty still a mystery to you and I. Don't cry, my darling, for it need not be. I to you, and you belong to me. Oh, flower, can be found.
That's a great sound of the Strangers there. Pringle Sims on lead by request. For Gordy Freeman in our YouTube chat room, April 1954 on the King label. Blue Flowers is the name of the tune for you collectors out there. If it's got that thick print, it's the second press. Got to be really thin print for that. But that's not a mint copy. Doesn't really sound that bad, I have to say. And I meant the gay tunes. The Gay Tunes on the Timely label. That's what I meant. I was getting confused because I have a Gay Larks coming up next as we head out to the West Coast, as this group was very popular in the Bay Area out in California. They had 6 releases on Ray Dobard's Music City label out of Berkeley, California. This is a request for listener Bob Evans. He requested their 2nd release, co-written by the lead singer. His name is Ben Richards. And this is one of the records I got from Seymour Simon, because he took a trip out to Music City Records when he was collecting. Then when he decided to sell out, and I started bidding on his 45s, it was Gold Mine, I think. He called me privately to sell me certain records. This was one of them here from 1955. These are the Gay Larks, going out to Bob Evans on the Music City record label. It's called Little Dream Girl.
I'll tell you, girl, tell the world how you're part of me. Ask everybody, tell them why, girl, you're my desire. Dream, girl, girl, if my dream come true, I'd have you. Dream girl, girl of my dreams, come true.
Dream girl.
Those are the Gaylarks. The Gaylarks from 1955. That's going out to Bob Evans listening in Ohio. That's their second release on Music City Records. Ben Richards on lead, Little Dream Girl. Going to flip it over next week for Hoseway in our YouTube chat room there. It was funny when I used to, when I was talking to, jeez, JohnnyG losing his mind here. Short-term memory loss here. Seymour Simon, he was telling me how he used to buy records. I think he was in time. He was buying from Times Square Records at the time. And, you know, it's not that people were buying records that were mint. You just bought the record no matter what. Because he would sell me some really clean records. And others were not so clean, like his Whispers on Gotham, which I ended up buying. That was not a clean record, but I didn't have it, and he had it, and he said, I want you to play these on the R&B review. Of course, I never had my chance to do that. I would have loved to be one of the hosts on the R&B review, but that never came to fruition. Although I was there, I definitely was there, but someone didn't want me to be. We're not going to go into that one. JohnnyG here on a Saturday evening as I have to stop my babbling here. Hope you're digging on the cool tunes here. Now, the Dominoes return, this time with a request for Daniel Kubacki in our YouTube chat room. We heard them earlier in the show from 52, featured their rendition of When the Swallows Come Back to Capistrano, but they would leave Federal in August of 1954, or they signed with Jerry Blaine's Jubilee record label in August of 1954. I think it was their seventh release on Federal, they became, instead of the Dominoes, they became Billy Ward and the Dominoes. Now, Ward wrote this tune, their second of two, on the Jubilee record label, and that's it. There were no more releases. I think they recorded five songs for Jerry Blaine, but he put out four of them. And this is from July 55. It features Jackie Wilson on lead. This is for Daniel Kubacki, Billy Ward, and the Dominoes on Jubilee. It's called Take Me Back to Heaven.
Take me. Silver wings. Once you called me angel
of mine.
An angel, then was I.
An angel was I.
But take me back to heaven. Clouds of dreams and roses schemes, we sailed to heaven's door. Some father love found you. Take me back to heaven, to be with you.
That's the sound of early Jackie Wilson with Billy Ward and his Dominoes, July 1955, the second of two on Jerry Blaine's Jubilee record label. Take Me Back to Heaven is the name of the tune. Some of these songs can take you definitely back to heaven. They're so great to hear. People don't sing like this anymore, folks. This is really the only way you can hear. Well, it's not really the only way, but at least the show that I do, very unique way of doing a collector type show here. I wish what all the shows that I used to listen to back in the 70s, early 70s were like this, where you can view the 45s, especially for a collector that has never seen. And again, I was a young collector listening to a lot of shows, and I would only see some of these records at record shows or whoever would post photos of them. I remember was it LC Docs? Is that the guy that used to, but he used to put out pictures of 78s, which I love to look at, because the 78 labels, some of them are really cool and some of them completely different from the 45 labels. Johnny G babbling on here. We are in the year 1955, and here's another tune I used to hear a lot on the Gus Gossard Show. You know this group from Newport News, Virginia. They left Aladdin Records in August of 1954 to sign with Capitol Records to have 19 releases between October 54 and November 58. Now, listener Bob Evans in Ohio requested their second release, this tune written by Chuck Willis. It features Marilyn Pierce on lead, and you'll hear the echoing in the background by the great Rudy West. He's doing the echoing part. This charted number 5 on the Billboard R&B charts, was a big number one record if you were listening to WCAE in Pittsburgh, PA. It's going out to Bob Evans, January 55, the 5 Keys on the Capitol label, and their tune called Close Your Eyes.
Close your eyes. Take a deep breath. Open your heart.
Open your heart.
And whisper.
I love you, I love you, I love you.
Tell me you love me.
You love me.
Tell me you love me.
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 Hold me tight.
Hold me tight.
Don't say
night. Don't say goodnight.
We have time.
Lots of time.
Everything alright.
Things gonna be alright.
Hold me, darling.
Never let me go.
Darling, and tell me.
And tell me.
You love me. No, no, no,
no, no, no. Even though
this is not the way I want it to be. But if you got to pretend,
let's pretend,
that's all right with me. Take a deep breath.
Open your heart.
and whisper,
I love you, I love you, I love you.
Tell me you love me.
You love me.
Tell me you love me.
You love me.
You love me.
I love you, darling, with all my heart and soul.
Yeah, there you go, the five keys there. I like that record. Their earlier sounds, at least that one is good. It's just, I just like that record. I remember hearing it on the Gus Gossard show. There you go, Marilyn Pierce on lead, Rudy West in the background there, January 1955. That's for Bob Evans, Close Your Eyes. You can't close your eyes, not when you're watching Johnny G here on YouTube. Tell your friends about it. If you're new to the program, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the thumbs up button if you will. Thank you, folks. As we continue here, we are in 1956 now. Now, here's a request for listener Joe Shacatano in our YouTube chat room. Thanks for the phone call, Joe. This, when I was pulling out 45s the other day. Now, this female singer was crippled since birth, but it didn't stop her from winning Amateur Night at the Apollo Theater back in 1951, and from that win, she was awarded a contract from Herman Lubinsky, owner of Savoy Records. Now, after her 10 releases on the Savoy label, she signed with the RCA subsidiary Groove Late Records to have 5 releases. Now, Joe requested her second. She's being backed up by a group called the Four Students, aka the Q's, backing her up. This is going out to Joe from April 56. Veretta Dillard with the Four Students on the Groove label. It's called Cherry Blossom. For Joe Shacatano in our YouTube chat room there, Veretta Dillard with the Four Students, a.k.a. The Q's, their April 1956 release on Groove Records, Cherry Blossom, the name of that one. And, of course, she followed, I think, after her Groove releases, she had releases on the parent label RCA Records. Also, in her early 60s on the Cub label. She's got a couple good ones that I like on the Cub label. Johnny G here on a Saturday evening. We're here from 9 p.m. Eastern time till midnight. We'll be doing overtime, at least a half hour of overtime. I don't have the helper downstairs. She texted me this morning. She said, Johnny G, I do not feel well. I went for a COVID test and I have COVID. I have a sore throat. I said, well, Delphi, you cannot come here. You cannot come here tonight. No way. We're going to be fine. We're fine. Well, yeah, we are fine. That is Johnny G getting back to normal, as I'm so glad I can come back and back to reality to do this show. Hope you're digging on the tunes tonight. We are in the year 1956. Now, on last week's Vinyl Treasure Show, I featured the Parakeets on Thomas Robinson's Atlas record label. I played the B-side to their debut single. It was called The Rain Starts to Fall. Now, listener Daryl Letts requested the A-side, which features Preston Fields and Leroy Williams on lead with Pete Martin, who wrote the tune On the Bridge. So this is for Daryl Letts in our YouTube chat room, April 56, same month and year release as the Veretta Diller tune. These are the Parakeets on Atlas. It's called I Have a Love. For Daryl Letts in our YouTube chat room, the sound of the Parakeets there from April 1956. Thomas Robinson's Atlas record label, I Have a Love. I have to admit, I heard that on the Time Capsule show the first time, which prompted me to buy the Best of Atlas Angle Tone. I was not happy with the sound quality of those LPs on the Relic label, but Relic put them out. I'm sure the CDs probably sound better. I don't know, but those Relic LPs with all those records, and you hear actually some unreleased stuff with the chatter in the background. It's really interesting, but of course, That's how I heard about this record. And of course, you know, I was buying everything that I could on the Atlas label, but the Vic Don and the Parakeets also. Johnny G babbling on here. Let's move into 1957 now. This is a request for listener Jimmy Amato. Jimmy, maybe you know more about this record. You and Louie went record hunting in the Midwest, and he turned up this record. Maybe he was the first to find this record. It's a rare 45. On the J&M record label. The group is called the Miracle Tones. I normally play the A side of this. It's called Tell Me Darling, but Jimmy requested the flip. So we're going to give it a spin here from June 1957. They're called the Miracle Tones. This is on the J&M record label. The song is called Mambo Train. This is for Jimmy Amato in our YouTube chat room.
I know you've heard about Mambo City.
Walk.
You've heard about the Mambo Dance.
Walk.
Let me ask you a question.
Walk.
Have you heard about the Mambo Train? You go
choo-choo. Walk.
June 1957 release there for a group called the Miracle Tones. That is the B-side of the 45 called Mambo Train. Came out on the J&M record label. That's for Jimmy Amato in our YouTube chat room. I bought it for Tell Me Darling. Spence sold me the record. It was like, Spence, I never saw this record before. And I played it on the turntable. I said, well, I got to have it. It wasn't cheap, I can tell you that much. Johnny G spinning original vinyl 45s and... that is Gail. Gail, the year is June of 57 is for that Miracle Tones. We stay in 57. Let's go back out to the West Coast with a request for listener Ronnie Sherman. And shortly after Richard Berry and the Pharaohs released Louie Louie on the Flip record label, they went back into the studio and recorded their next 45 as the Cyclones. And the song written by Richard Berry, who was singing bass on this, he's not singing lead. The lead singer is Godoy Colbert. He is the lead. And sounds like Berry's also on the bridge and the chorus here. So this is going out to Ronnie Sherman, June 1957. These are the Cyclones on the Flip label. It's called My Dear. This is for Ronnie.
My dear,
That's a sock smoker for Mike Sape, Rob Balboni, and also we're going to say Butch Ford, the great sound of the Cyclones there by request for Ronnie Sherman, June 1957. It's on the Flip record label. My Dear is the name of the tune. We are in 1957. The lead singer of this next group was born in Birmingham, Alabama, but he relocated to New York City. He became a member of the Sparks of Rhythm. They recorded for the Apollo record label and then became the lead singer of many a name of vocal groups like the Savoys on Savoy, the Jones Boys on the Arrow label, and the Pretenders on the Rama label, and Whirling Disc and Holiday labels, Central and Apt labels, there you go. But not to mention, he had a very successful solo career beginning in 1959, recording for Cub Records. You know the song Handyman, Good Time, and two of his bigger hits there. Now, listener Joe Shacatano requested their release on Bobby Robinson's Whirling Disc record label. I don't know, Big Dave Swinger, if this is brown vinyl. I will check, possibly, these promos are, but the tune written by ex-Vocaliers member Joe Duncan, of course featuring the lead of Jimmy Jones. We go to February 1957 for the Pretenders. This is for Joe Shacatano in our YouTube chat room on Whirling Disc Records. It's called Close Your Eyes, parentheses, Sleep and Dream.
Close your eyes. Don't worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will be gay as it was today for you and me. Sleep and dream, cast out all your sorrow, for there'll be no one but you, and I'll be true to only you. But once, my dear, with smile and be cheerful, for I love you, yes, I do. So close your eyes, don't you worry.
our tomorrow. For tomorrow will be gay as it was today for you and me.
February 1957 release there for Jimmy Jones and the Pretenders there on Whirling Disc Records. Close Your Eyes is the name of the tune. That one there going out to Joe Shacatano in our YouTube chat. When we stay in 1957, this is an ultra rare 45. This is by request for Gordy Freeman in our YouTube chat room. Now it's on William Henry Miller's Acme record label. The group is out of Glen Cove, Long Island, and it's their actually it's not their debut single. Their debut single was in 1956 for Al Silver's Herald label, but this was their second overall release, and this was my number one vote in the 1957 Relic Rack survey. I used to vote in those surveys, and I used to tune in to WFUV to listen to the countdown. I think they would play, was it the top 100 or 200 records? But anyway, I remember when I bought this record, I bought it from Ken Thompson. He told me this story. He found three copies at a garage sale. Now, I think he charged me at the time was $600 for the 45. It's not mint, and it plays decent. Okay, but where are you going to find this record? It's really hard to find this 45. It features Henry Williamson on lead. This is going out to Gordy Freeman in our YouTube chat room, September 1957. Give a listen to the Sunbeams on the Acme label. It's called Please Say You'll Be Mine.
Please.
jazz by request for Gordy Freeman in our YouTube chat room. The great sound of the Sunbeams on the Acme record label, Please Say You'll Be Mine. Henry Williamson, the lead singer on that, September 1957. I've played this record a lot. A lot. I used to do a bunch of guest spots when I used to go up to Middletown, Connecticut with Al Bernard. Also played it on a couple other, but I've been playing it a lot. I'm wearing my copy out. Where am I going to find a mint copy of that? It's really hard. I'm sure they're out there, but it's going to be big bucks. That is for sure. But that is a great song. And that was my number one record from 1957. Thanks for requesting that one, Gordy. Let's continue. Here we are in 1957. Let's go back out to California with this request for listener Daniel Kubacki. Now, this group's signature song was way back in July of 1954, recorded for Dootsie Williams' Dootone record label. I'm sure you know the song. It was called The Letter. It featured a couple of made-up words. You know what those two words were? It was Sweet Words of Pismotality. What? And the Puppetus. Of Love? What is that? What does that mean? Anyway, Daniel requested the A-side to their ninth of 12 on Dootsie Williams' Dootone/Dooto record labels. This one's on Dooto, written by lead singer Vernon Green. Let's go to June of 1957 for Vernon Green and the Medallions on the Dooto label. It's called For Better or For Worse.
For better or for worse, I'll always love you. If you be true, then I will say I do. Of far ways, we'll walk down the aisle. You dressed in white, with me wearing a smile. Oh yes, and I'll promise. Yes, 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 to be true. Yes, 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 and always. Yes, 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 and I'll always love you for better or for less. In that little white house where we raise a family. Oh yes, and I'll promise. Yes, 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 to be true. Yes, and I'll always. Yes, 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 and I'll always love you for better or for worse. We'll live happily in that little white house where we'll raise a family.
And raise a family. And raise a family. And raise a family.
That's Vernon Green and the Medallions. That's going out to Daniel Kubacki in our YouTube chat room. June 1957 on the Dooto record label, For Better or For Worse. is the name of the tune. Marvin Pod, it's your birthday today. It's my father's birthday today, February 4th. It was 92. Actually, it was pretty nice. My sister-in-law Jill and Michael came up. They made stuffed shells, and my sister Lori and her husband Terrence were here, and we sang happy birthday, and at least it put him in a happy mood. He blew out the candles there. Actually, Jill bought number 92, so he's doing well. He can climb the stairs pretty well. Just a few things mentally we need to work on, but he is doing really well. But it's his birthday, 92 years old today. Johnny G here on a Saturday evening. Hope you're digging on the cool tunes here. We count down the music chronologically here. We're here till midnight. We'll be doing overtime. Lots of requests. We are in 1957, but let's stay in Los Angeles, California, with this request for Jim Lampley, listening in Texas. It's on Max Furtag's Flip label. We heard earlier from the Cyclones on the Flip record label. This singer previously was the lead singer of the Crowns, but here is a solo effort on the Flip label, although not really solo, because the Crowns are backing him up on this, but they are uncredited. The song written by Richard Berry. This is going out to Jim. December 57 release for Arthur Lee May and the Crowns on the Flip record label. It's called Cause You're Mine Alone. This is for Jim.
Cause you're mine, I'll give you my heart and soul. Cause you're mine, I'll give you my heart and soul. And I can smile all the while, cause you are mine. Cause you're mine, life is so sweet. Cause you're mine, love is such a treat. And I can smile all the while, cause you are
going out to listener Jim Lampley in Texas. That's Arthur Lee May and the Crowns backing him up. They're uncredited. December 57 release on the Flip label. Cause You're Mine Alone is the name of the tune. Now, Arthur Lee May would work at two professions, and one as a professional baseball player. I think he played with the Milwaukee Braves, I think. You know, I had Arthur LeMay baseball cards that my father threw in the garbage. You believe that? They were down in the basement. Of course, I didn't keep good care of them. They were in shoe boxes. But when somebody dropped them on the floor. I mean, I had probably about 300 or 400 cards from different years, of course. Some of them were hand-me-downs from my older cousins that I would meet up with. They were really cool because I used to be a great flipper of baseball cards. You know, when you flip the cards, you try to get them either face up or face down. And if somebody, you know, if you make an error, like, you know, if they mess up, they can mess up too, but they can't mess up three times, you know, and then you win all the cards. Then I used to like to play colors and teams and all those cool things with the baseball cards. But anyway, he played for the Milwaukee Braves and also his other profession as a singer. And Johnny G here, not a profession, just an amateur DJ here on a Saturday night, spinning my original vinyl 45s. We are in 1957. Now, last week I played a request for listener Kenny Mack in our YouTube chat room. The group was from the Bronx, New York. The lead singer was 12-year-old Ralph Molina, and his release was on Andy Leonetti's Safari record label. The side I featured, or that Kenny requested, was called Whoa Whoa Baby. The group was known as the Personalities. Now, listener Daryl Letts requested the flip side of this 45. Now, I found out some cool information about the lead singer of this group. I had a nice phone call with collector Chris Varelis. He called me up out of the blue. It was nice talk. I mean, I couldn't really talk that long because I had to do something, either give my father lunch or whatever, but or had to go to the dentist. I wonder if it was that Wednesday. I don't know. But Chris told me he wanted to email me during the show last week. He told me that that Ralph Molina, the lead singer, was the drummer for Neil Young's band Crazy Horse. And so I didn't know that. I thought that was pretty cool information. Not that he was telling me that, you know, it was like kind of like, you know, shrugging off that he was the lead singer of a group called the Personalities back in 1957, which, you know, I think when you find singers and you kind of talk about, like I would do, if I found a singer that I knew was on a record that I really loved, and I would say, you know, you got a great record there. They don't really hear that much, even nowadays, if they're still around. But anyway, this is for Daryl Letts. This is the B-side, September 57, The Personalities on the Safari label. It's called Yours to Command. This is for Daryl.
My life and my love,
B-sides here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. That one there going out to Daryl Letts in our YouTube chat room. The Personalities. Personalities with Crazy Horse drummer on lead, 12-year-old at the time, Ralph Molina, September 1957, Yours to Command on the Safari record label. And one more side note that Chris mentioned, and I knew this though, that that the band Crazy Horse originated as Danny and the Memories, that recorded for the Valiant label back in 1964. Johnny G here spinning my 45s. Hope you're digging on the cool tunes here. If you're new to the program here on YouTube, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, click the thumbs up, and tell your friends about it. We want to get up to 1,000 subscribers here before the end of the year. So then I'll be doing some other specials here, I will. Thinking about it here, you guys been sending me some cool suggestions. You can send them to me at vinyltreasures@aol.com. We are in 1958 now. Now, I was saddened, really, to hear the passing of Charlie Thomas, one of the many leads of the Drifters. He died January 31st, 2023 from liver cancer at the age of 85. So I wanted to pay tribute to Charlie and play his very first record that he sang on. Now, he was a member of this group called The Crowns, which included Benjamin Earl Nelson, and you know who he is. He sang as Benny King, and he would, of course, become the lead of the Drifters. But the group also included James Papa Clark, Doc Green Jr., Ellsbury Hobbs, and Charlie Thomas. Now, this group would record as the New Drifters in 1959. They would sign with Atlantic Records. But this particular song, written by Doc Pomus and Mort Schumann, they released this on their own label. They own this label, R&B Records. And it features the late Charlie Thomas on lead. This is the first record he sang on, and he did lead on this. This charted number 3 on KASL in Newcastle, Wyoming, of all places. Let's go to February 1958 for The Crowns as we pay tribute to the late Charlie Thomas. This is on R&B Records, and he's singing lead on this. It's called Kiss and Make Up.
Come on.
February 1958, release there for The Crowns on the R&B record label, featuring the late Charlie Thomas on lead. Kiss and Make Up is the name of that tune. I think Benny King, he's doing lead on the flip side of that, if I'm not mistaken. Anyway, but as we pay tribute to the late Charlie Thomas, let's stay in 1958. Let's go to Elizabeth, New Jersey. This is a request for Adrian Viterbo. He's listening in Mexico, and it's the debut single for this group. It's the first of three on the C&M record label, Castino Queen and Mary Linkowitz's C&M record label. I have a nice copy of this. Well, the wax is nice on this. It's the label that has some water damage, but I found this in the wild for, 25 cents back in my younger days of collecting. But I like this tune. It's their first of three on the C&M record label. This is for Adrian. It features a Darnell Lamb on lead. This is from November 58. Let's give a listen to the Noble Tones on C&M. It's called Who Cares About Love for Adrian.
Who cares about love?
I care about love.
Who got a new star?
I got
a new star. Oh, where are you?
Where are you?
Please come back to me.
Oh, come back to me.
By request for Adrian Viterbo. I like that record there. That's Darryl Lamb on lead with the Noble Tones, November 1958, their first release on the C&M record label. Who Cares About Love is the name of the tune. Now, C&M would later become the Wagner record label. I have a Wagner 45 coming up in a little bit. As we continue here, we are in the year 1958, as we stay there with this request, actually for two listeners, for Jay Perk. I think last week Jay Perk mentioned this in the chat room. Also, Kenny Mack, you requested this one too. The group members lived on 115th Street in Manhattan, if anybody knows where that is. I do not, but it's the same apartment building as the Bop Chords, which is pretty cool, but it's too bad they only had two releases. First recording for Danny Robinson's Holiday record label, you know the song Counting the Stars. stars. They followed it up with this release on Danny Robinson's Vest label. Now, the group consisted of first tenor Herb Jennings, second tenor Irvin Jones, baritone Ron Clark, the bass is Douglas Jackson, and the lead singer Johnny Jackson. Collectively, they were known as the Ladders. This is going out to Kenny and Jay Perk, 1958. The Ladders on the Vest label. It's called Hey, Pretty Baby.
Bio, bio, bio. Bio, bio.
JohnnyG getting caught. I wanted to show you the two copies of this next record here, and of course I get caught. Oh well. Don't tell Sugar Bear Sterling. Anyway, there you go. So there you go. Great sound of the Ladders there from 1958. That's on the Vest record label. That's going out to Kenny Mack and Jay Perk, the Ladders with Hey Pretty Baby. Now, this tune written by their manager, Les Cooper. Les Cooper, of course, involved with the charts. Also, he had, what was it, Wiggle Wobble? Well, yeah, on Wiggle, wait, Les Cooper, no. What was the instrumental hit that, oh man, COVID really attacking Johnny's brain here. Les Cooper, he had something on Everlast. And, oh gosh, somebody's going to think of it. Now, for you collectors out there, the true first press of this, is without the stars. That's the one that I played. Spence sold me that copy. Really, it's hard to find without the stars, I have to tell you. You can find the one with the stars, which is the second, around the Vest logo. I love the Rodans on Vest. That's a great record. Johnny G babbling on here for not Rinky Dink. Wiggle Wobble. There you go. Daryl said it. I'm losing my mind. Let's continue here. And we go back out to California with this request for Arizona listener Stephen Cargman. This came out on Imogene Fidali's Tender label, and this group included Henry Dunstan, Ron Ellington, Freddie Flammer, Mitchell Perker, and James Thompson. Collectively, they were known as the Five Trojans originally. But then they actually became the Trojans. I showed you the two different copies that you can tell how different they look, really. So this is for Steve Cargman, September 58, the Five Trojans on the Tender label. It's called Don't Ask Me to be lonely. Going out to Steve Cargman there, September 1958. That record's as old as your host, Johnny G. The Five Trojans on the Tender record label. Don't Ask Me to Be Lonely. Charlene, you got to put five before that. I didn't put five. I copied in Trojans. You got to put five there. But anyway, this would be re-released a month later as the Trojans, as I mentioned. And the group would have two more releases. They got Zola? What, Edison International? They have a release on Edison International, also on the Triangle label. Anyway, let's continue. We move into 1959. Let's go to Chicago, Illinois with this next release for listener Timothy in our YouTube chat room. It's on Leonard Chess's Argo label, and the only release for this group, Duke Savage, and I don't know if he wanted to be called the Arabians. No, it says Arabians, Arribins. I guess that's what it is. But anyway, written by Cleveland Savage, a relative to Duke Savage, I guess. But anyway, I have no other info on this group. It came out in September 59. This is for Timothy, Duke Savage and the Arabians on the Argo label. It's called Hey Baby.
I love you so. Let's go out, honey, and do the town. Then we'll hug, kiss, dance, and dine. You said the food was good. Champagne was fine. Oh, but no
That is it has a gospel flavor to that record, that is for sure. That's for Timothy. The group called Duke Savage and the Arabian, September 1959. That's on the Argo label. Song entitled Hey Baby. Johnny G here till midnight. We'll go a little bit longer there. We'll be going to it. We're going to be doing a lot of overtime here. Got lots of requests here. We are in the year 1959. Now, earlier I played the Noble Tones on the C&M record label out of Elizabeth, New Jersey. On the C&M records owned by Castino Queen and Mary Linkowicz. The label then became Wagner Records, and they recorded this group out of East Orange, New Jersey. Features the lead singer Ronald Smalls. He's on lead, and it's a request for Ronnie Sherman. Let's give a listen to this group called The Blenders. The Blenders out of New Jersey from July 59 on Wagner Records. It's called Angel for Ronnie.
I fell in love with an angel. I fell in love with a dog. And every time she passes by, I call to her. Something else. She gives me such a wonderful thrill. If anyone should take her away, I would love her still. She knows how
to Ronnie Sherman there. Nice sound by the Blenders. The Blenders out of Elizabeth, New Jersey. Ronald Smalls on lead, July 1959. Angel is the name of the tune. That's on the Wagner record label. We stay in 1959. How about a twin spin with two different groups called the Teen Kings? And this is a request for both these songs by Arizona listener Steve Cargman. Now, both of these records released in 1959. Now, first up, a very rare 45 out of Reading, Pennsylvania. I was playing around with my focusing. I have to see, it's, I can get the labels to, I know you guys would rather prefer the close-up labels to look clear, so I have to play with the focus, but it puts the backdrop out of focus at a certain thing. I don't know if it's the light or what, but I want to adjust the focus a little better so you can see the labels much clearer. I think that's the most important thing. So I will fix that for next week. But up first, the ultra rare 45 out of Reading, Pennsylvania. It's on Grover Barber and Russ Golding's B label. And they also get the writer credited on this. Now, prior to this release, the group recorded as the Del Reys on the Chord label. That's another rare 45. Chord Records in 1958. I have that release also. But this was their very next release as the Teen Kings. It features Walter Buster Lockman on lead. This is from February 59 by request for Steve Cargman. Where are you getting these rare records, Steve? The Teen Kings on the B label. If you could understand the lyrics, send them to Johnny G, because I don't. It's called That's a Teenage Love. This is for Steve.
Cha la la, cha la la, cha la la la, woo yeah. Cha la 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 la, woo. Cha la 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 la, woo. Cha la 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 la, woo. Cha la 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 la, woo. Hey, hey, hey.
What I say, what I see, what I imagine, live beneath, ain't nothing, ain't nothing.
That's our first one by the Teen Kings. They're out of Reading, Pennsylvania, February 1959. The Teen Kings on the B label. That's a Teenage Love. You can kind of make your own lyrics to that, because a great beat, but what are they saying? So, Joel, I'm going to hold you to it. If you can give me the lyrics to that song, that would be wonderful. I will say, but that's Walter Buster Lockman on lead. Now, many of the originals of this 45 that were pressed were destroyed by the record company for some legal reason. I don't know exactly what it is, but the group later would record as the Delights. I featured them last week on the Night label. That was the same group. And also, they recorded as the Delights on the Cuppy label. That's a rare Northern Soul record, which I have featured on my All 60s show that the Northern Soul collectors are looking for. But that's a rare 45 from February 59, the Teen Kings. Let's give a listen to the other Teen Kings that Steve Carman requested. And this group is from North Versailles, Pennsylvania. This came out on Elmer Ouellette's Willett record label, and it's actually a cover tune. This song was first recorded back in 1958 by Johnny Jones and the Five Chords on the Jamie label. They did it first, but this was the cover from November 59 going out to Stephen Cargman, the Teen Kings, number two on the Willett label, and their rendition of the tune, Don't Just Stand There.
Start a fire. Whoa, I've been yearning.
Cover tunes here on the Vinyl Treasure Show, November 1959, the Teen Kings. The Teen Kings on the Willett record label, covering the Five Chords tune, Don't Just Stand There. Johnny G, not just standing, I'm spinning my 45s, I should stand up. Don't want to get any blood clots in my leg, God forbid. And I don't know, I don't want to take Eliquis. Both my parents are on Eliquis. That is an expensive drug. I will tell you it is, as we continue here, and we go back to Los Angeles, California, with this request for Joe Shacatano. Now, when lead singer Johnny Stanton left the Feathers, he decided to form a new group. He called them the Individuals. They had two releases on the Showtime record label. I think this was the A-side called Jungle Superman. I think that was it. But Joe requested their second release. They had different flip sides. The first one and the second one, the flip sides of Jungle Superman. But this is the second release. And it's actually this group. Johnny Stanton did a song with the Feathers on Hollywood Records called Dear One. This is a reworking of that song. Again, I think that one was in 56. And this one is from October of 1959. And this is going out to Joe Shacatano, October 59, the Individuals on the Showtime record label. It's called Dear One. This is for Joe.
Dear One, You are the only girl I could ever
love.
That I'll swear to all
stars above,
and I'll promise to be true.
To be true.
You know it seems.
I've never seen,
leaving all my love
for you.
I said it, nobody knows now, till then the love that night, when I'm alone.
Of California here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. That's for Joe Shacatano, the Individuals, October 1959 on the Showtime label. You can also pick this up on a reissue from 65 on Red Fox, but I don't think the sound quality is that good. But the song is called Dear One. As we continue here, we are in 1959. Here is a request for Hawaiian listener, or out in Hawaii, listening out in Hawaii. He just broke for lunch about 15 minutes ago. Butch Ford, and he requested this on the Ace label, not to be confused with Johnny Vincent's label out of Mississippi. This label is out of New York City, and I would guess the group is also out of New York City. I don't know anything else about it. It's not an easy 45 to find, from March 1959. This is for Butch, the Sharp Tones on Ace. It's called I'll Always Remember.
School's on most of that. Soon.
Going out to Butch Ford there. That's a hard record to find, the Sharp Tones. From March 1959 on the Ace record label out of New York City. Used to find a lot of these Ace records locally. Not this one, though, and it's on the promo. It's not on the blue label there. Sharp Tones, a song entitled I'll Always Remember. I hope I get to the other one, Butch, from 64. The other I'll Always Remember that you requested on the Gordy label. So we'll see how that goes. But let's continue in 1959. Another singer that we recently lost at the end of January was Barrett Strong. He died on January 28th, 2023 at the age of 81, probably best known for his song called Money, That's What I Want. He was actually the first artist to have a hit for the Berry Gordy Jr.'s Motown empire. But let's give a spin to his debut single, which is really ultra rare. It's not easy to find, as I was offered this record many years ago by Carl Pellegrino. He was a big Motown collector, has a lot of knowledge on Motown, and he sold me a few records, like a couple of the JVB records, some really expensive records. This was one of them. I think he got it from one of the people that worked for Berry Gordy Jr. had some copies of records. But I normally feature the up-tempo side of this called Let's Rock. But The Flip is an interesting ballad with a vocal group in the background. There is a vocal group also on Let's Rock, but I've never played this side. And we're going to dedicate this to the memory of the late Barrett Strong. And I think Jerry Nazz, and I got your message about the Barrett Strong. I'll be featuring some of his records also this coming Wednesday night. Couldn't do the show last Wednesday because I had a tooth extracted. I'm talking pretty good with the stitches in my mouth. The bleeding has stopped, but what a pain in the neck. But anyway, this is from April 59, the late Barrett Strong on the Tamla record label. It's called Do the Very Best You Can.
Do the very best you can with what you have. Do the very best you can
what
is what
make it. You can
break
it, but the grass always seems greener on the other side. Do the very best you can. What you have.
Late Barrett Strong there, April 1959. It's on the Tamla record label, Do the Very Best You Can. Marvin Pod mentions that he's related to Nolan Strong, of course. You would assume that for sure, but we play tribute to the late Barrett Strong with that debut single by him on the Tamla record label. Let's move into 1960 now with a request for listener Kenny Mack in our YouTube chat room, as this next group, they're from New Haven, Connecticut. They started back in 1958 on the Alert record label. They followed it up with this release on Bobby Robinson's Fury Records, written by Vinnie Catalano. The lead singer on this is the late Roger Koob. This is from January 1960. This is for Kenny Mack. Give a listen to the premieres on Fury. It's called Pigtail Eyes Are Blue.
Pigtails, eyes are blue, kisses warm, you're my girl. At last I found
going out to Kenny Mack. Kenny Mack, that's Roger Koob and the Premieres. January 1960 release on Fury Records. Pigtail, Eyes Are Blue, the name of the tune. They have other releases. Rust Records. What is that? Something about Star, Shining Star, or something with Star in it, which is a good song. Also recorded for as Roger and the Travelers on Ember. Also recorded as the Buddies on the Comet label. And the Frontiers on Philips. They have some nice releases as the Frontiers. And also, I think, on MGM2. Johnny G here on a Saturday evening. Hope you're digging on the cool tunes tonight. If you're new to the program, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can contact me. You can send me your requests at vinyltreasures@aol.com. Don't be bashful. If I have the 45, I'll feature it for you. Have been getting some requests that were in my uncleaned or unfiled boxes, so it's been taking me some time to get there. I will get there eventually, so continue to send me your requests as we continue here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. We move into 1961. This is an old request for listener Joe Shakitano. We go to Brooklyn, New York for this group. It's their first of two on the Honor record label by a group called The Honorables. How appropriate. On the Honor label, The Honorables, the first of two. It actually kicked off the label, Honor number 100 from February 61. This is for Joe, The Honorables with Castle in the Sky. That's the sound of The Honorables, the first of two they did on the Honor label. That's for Joe Shakitano in our YouTube chat room, February 61. Song entitled Castle in the Sky. We stay in 1961. We go back with another request. Kenny Mack putting his requests close together in years. This is for Kenny Mack. It's a rare 45 by this group out of Long Island, and it's their only release on a label called Clawwell, which is out of Staten Island. Now, the song written by David Mapp. He is also the lead singer of the group. This is for Kenny Mack from May 61. They're called the Infascinations on Clawwell Records. It's called I'm So In Love.
I'm so in love.
In love.
In love.
Won't do.
I can't go on.
Go on.
Geez, I thought they were going to do another verse there. I wanted to answer Kenny Mack in the chat room there. But those are the Infascinations. That's by request for Kenny Mack, May 1961. David Mapp, the lead singer on that. I'm So In Love is the name of the tune. It's on the Clawwell record label. Now, for you collectors out there, check your copy if you own this. If you could bend it and it's the vinyl copy, that's not the original. I think, what did I pay for that? I think I paid $20 for that copy, but these are much more. The styrene press, that is the original. You know that Johnny hates styrene 45s, although that's, you know, played okay. It's just, I hate the crackle with it. I mean, if you got a nice mint copy and it plays nice and you don't overplay it with a heavy needle or a bad needle, then you're fine. But that's how it is with the styrene 45s, unfortunately. And thank you, that person who said my voice. It's funny, when I, because I met Barbara in 2010, my girlfriend Barbara, on Match.com. And one of the girls, or, you know, that I knew, she said, why don't you, what is like the best thing that would know about you? I said, my voice. And it was funny, when I was on that other radio station, when it was owned by a real manager, Delana, she said she liked my baritone voice. She said it was a soothing voice to listen to. So she said, and that's when I, you know, had my first show back in 2005 on that other radio station. But I guess I played too much as far as funeral music goes, it was put. But anyway, thank you all for being here, listening to my records, and for your requests, as this is really the only time I get to listen to all my records. So let's continue here. And here's a request for Timothy in our YouTube chat room. This group is out of Nashville, Tennessee. They had two releases on the Dot label. This is their second. And you may know a member of this group. His name is Robert Peebles. And he would go on to have success in 1967 on the Rising Suns record label with a song called Everlasting Love, if you know that song. But it's done by Robert Knight. And he was a member of this group prior to recording that, of course. But this group is called The Paramounts, and I like this song. And this is a request for Timothy from March 61, The Paramounts on the Dot label. It's called You're 17.
You're 17.
jazz going out to Timothy in our YouTube chat room, The Sound of the Paramounts, March 1961. That's their second of two on the Dot record label. You're 17. What would you give to be 17 again? Listen, I'd give anything to be 5 years younger than I am now anyway. But let's continue here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. And what do you say there? Great birthday from a great night. Okay, listen, Marvin, happy birthday to you as you share this day with my dad who turned 92 today. But let's continue here. You know the A-side of this 45 is done by this singer from Yuma, Arizona. And the song was called Pretty Little Angel Eyes. It was a 45 that my aunt purchased back in the spring of 1961, but we're going to flip that 45 over, even though as much as I like that big hit, but the flip side is actually a killer ballad written by Tommy Boyce. It was produced by Phil Spector and the backup group that are not credited on this. They were the Halos, which included Carl Spencer, Bobby Spencer, J.R. Bailey, and Gary Morrison. And this one from June of 1961, it's not an expensive 45, but it's a great 45. It's a great two-sider, in my opinion. You know, hits don't have to be rare, even the flip side. So let's give a listen to Curtis Lee and the uncredited Halos on the Dunes label. As I mentioned, June 61. It's called Gee, How I Wish You Were Here.
How I wish you were here tonight to love me and gee. How I miss you tonight. I need you here beside me. How I wish you were
B-sides here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. That's the B-side. It's a Pretty Little Angel Eyes. It's called Gee, How I Wish You Were Here, June 1961. Curtis Lee and the uncredited Halos on the Dunes record label. Besides their own material, the Halos provided backing vocals to the likes of Barry Mann, Benny King, Connie Francis, Tommy Hunt, Bobby Vinton, The Coasters, Brian Hyland, Johnny Nash, Dion, Little Eva, Gene Pitney, Shirley and Lee, Johnny Mathis, and others. Sort of like kind of how the Blossoms were singing background to groups out in California. The Halos were doing background singing for singers here on the East Coast. Phil Spector produced that one there. Tommy Boyce wrote the tune. Johnny G here on a Saturday evening, spinning original vinyl 45s. Tell your friends about it. We got to get up to 1,000 subscribers. Those of you that listen on the archive, please like. I get like 500, 600 people that watch the video. You can like the video. Would be excellent if you can. Let's continue here. We are in 1961, actually the end of 61 here for this one. And it's a request for listener Adrian Viterbo, listening in Mexico. It's out of Los Angeles, California, this gal. She was born Janelle Grimes. She was discovered by Richard Berry. Actually, Richard did a record with her as Ricky and Janelle. It came out on the Flair label. I have played it here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. I was going to pull it out for tonight. I just didn't get a chance. But she had other releases on the Dynamic label and on Amazon Records. Now, initially, or the first presses of this came out as Moments, and that's how I have it. But then it was released, I think, a month or two later as Moments to Remember, as Billboard reviewed this record in December of 1961. But, or maybe they did the second title, I don't remember. But actually, the second title in March of 62 made it to 69 on Cashbox, 50 on Billboard, 16 on the R&B charts. But this was a number one record on KTKT in Tucson, Arizona. This is going out to Adrian, December 61, Janelle Hawkins on Amazon Records. My copy says Moments. Going out to Adrian in Mexico there, December 61, Janelle Hawkins on the Amazon record label. Moments is the name of the tune. Actually, it says on the label here, which is interesting. It says the best from the best-selling album, The Many Moods of Janelle. Jenny. Does it say Jenny or Janelle? No, it says Jenny. That is weird. Is that a legitimate album? I wonder if that is. It says from the best-selling album, The Many Moods of Jenny. How weird. I don't know. That's odd. Anyway, let's continue here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. And we are 1962. Let's go to San... No, I'm sorry. I messed that up. Yeah, we are in... Let's go to 1962 with this request for Ronnie Sherman. This 45 is out of Wichita Falls, Texas. The group formed while they were all stationed at Shepherd Air Force Base. This is their first of two that came out on the Fidelity record label. I'm still looking for their second one, which I don't have, but I do have their first one. It features Nat Nixon on lead. This is going out to Ronnie Sherman, February 62. They're called the Banlons. Banlons, the Banlons on Fidelity. It's called Highest Mountain. This is for Ronnie.
Highest mountain, deeper than the deepest sea, that's how my love will long for you, dear. It will last till eternity.
February 1962 release by request for Ronnie Sherman, the Banlons. That's their first of two on the Fidelity label. Highest Mountain is the name of that one. Let's stay in 1962. We go out to San Bernardino, California with this old request for listener Amnon. And this group's biggest hit would have to be their debut single that came out on the Baronet record label, a killer ballad called Need Your Love. They followed it up with this release on the Baronet record label, their second of four. It features the lead of J.D. Wright. We go to August 1962 for the Metallics. The Metallics on Baronet Records. The song is called Drop By. This is for Amnon. Sounds of California here on the Vinyl Treader Show. That one by request for listener Amnon, August 62. They're called the Metallics. J.D. Wright and the Metallics, their second release on the Baronet record label. Drop By is the name of the tune. At 226 so far, Drop By to see Johnny G. Thank you all. I just hope you all become subscribers. We are in 1962. Let's go to this next request for Butch Ford, listening out in Hawaii. I can't tell you much about this group. They're called The Fables. The Fables, it's on the Elgo, E-L-G-O record label. I couldn't find this first because they have the writer and arranger in big print, Sam Gollard. And I had this record filed under Gollard. I'm going, what the hell is going on here? But I found it eventually. So this is for Butch Ford, August 62, The Fables on Elgo. It's called Angel.
Angel, angel.
Record there by the Fables, or Oddball record on the Elgo record label, August 62 release. Going out to Butch Ford, a song entitled Angel. We are in 1962. Now here's a request for listener Timothy. This group is out of Philadelphia, but this group is out of Philadelphia. This is their debut single on the Baltimore-based Chesapeake record label, and it features Tony Accione on lead. The group is called Tony and the Raindrops. This is for Timothy from 1962 on Chesapeake Records. It's called Our Love Is Over. This is for Timothy.
I know. by myself.
'62 there for Tony and the Raindrops. That's going out to Timothy in our YouTube chat room. Our Love Is Over. That one there on the Chesapeake record label. Now, they followed this up with a release on the Crosley label, and it's Rare 45 by them on the Crosley label. They would change the Tony, the lead singer, would change his name to Tony Devon, with releases on Jubilee, Polydor, and Red Line, probably going into the 1970s. And that singer, he also was an actor. Unfortunate that he passed away on February 26, 2022, at the age of 78. But to that one there, a cool tune. Although it is not over, we have just joined Oldies and More Radio. Want to welcome Oldies and More Radio to Johnny G's Vinyl Treasure Show. I'm here, usually here from 9 p.m. Eastern Time till midnight. We are doing overtime where we're carried on Oldies and More Radio, also live on the YouTube stream as we continue here. And another one here in 1962, actually a couple more in 62, as we go out to Los Angeles, California. This is a request for listener Tom Shaughnessy, watching Johnny G on his big 50-inch TV. Now, this is on Lou Bedell's Bamboo record label, also owned the Dore label. The group is called The Wonders. It features Don Thomas on lead. This is for Tom, June 62, a great two-sided 45 on the Bamboo label, The Wonders, with Please Don't Cry. This is for Tommy.
Ah!
They're called The Wonders. The Wonders going out to Tom Shaughnessy, August 62. Don Thomas, the lead singer on that, Please Don't Cry is the name of that one. Came out on Lou Bedell's Bamboo record label. We're going to play the flip next week, a great flip side with These Hands. But this group would later record on the Dore Parent label as The Symbols. I featured a couple weeks ago or longer than that their song called Last Year Around This Time, but they were first known as The Wonders. Let's stay in 62. Let's go to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania for this request for Kenny Mack in our YouTube chat room. This group made their debut on the Robbie label back in 1961. Two releases on the Robbie label. This is their third and final release that came out on Liberty Records. A tune written by the lead singer. His name is Frank Avery. This one produced by Clyde Otis. This is for Kenny Mack, March 62. They're called the Laurels. The Laurels on Liberty. It's called I Guess I'll Never Stop Loving You, for Kenny.
Hey, hey,
for Kenny Mack in our YouTube chat room. They're out of Pittsburgh. That's the final release for the Laurels. Frank Avery on lead, March 1962, came out on the Liberty record banner. I Guess I'll Never Stop Loving You, as we are in Vinyl Treasure Overtime. Thank you all for sticking around here listening to the Vinyl Treasure Show. Hope you're hearing some cool tunes that you like, maybe songs you never heard before. If you want to get in touch with Johnny G, send me an email at vinyltreasures@aol.com. If you have a request like Emnon does, as we move into 1963 with this Phil Spector related item. He wrote the tune, and this one arranged by Jack Nietzsche, produced by Lester Sill and Steve Douglas. All big production names here on this 45. Unfortunately, it was not a hit. It only charted regionally, made it up to number 41 on WHYN in Springfield, Massachusetts. It's a female lead with male backing. This is an old request for listener, no, maybe not an old request. It is a request for listener Emnon, April 63. Her name is Tony Jones. Tony Jones and group on the Smash label. The song is called Dear, parenthesis, Here Comes my baby.
Dear, 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 dear.
Going out to Amnon there. That's Tony Jones and Groove. Maybe they're the Halos. Maybe they're the Halos in the background there. I don't know. April 1963 on the Smash record label. Dear parentheses, here comes my baby. That stamped DJ with a BB hole. How odd that is. But really, that comes on the, I think mine is a, is it a green Smash label if I'm not mistaken? I don't remember, but I do have a promo of that too. Anyway, let's continue here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. We are in 1963. Now, a couple of weeks back, I received a request from Chuck Mitchell, who was in our YouTube chat room. He wanted to hear the Delmonicos, actually both sides of the 45. They were out of the East Harlem section of New York City, and I did play the A side of their Aku release called You Can Call. Now, Chuck also requested the Flip, and we're going to feature it tonight. I wasn't able to get it in last week. I had to rush downstairs, but this week I don't have the aid downstairs, so I can do in this overtime here. Now, it features Carlotti on lead, if I said that right. I don't know, Cariotti. There you go. JohnnyG with COVID fog here. And this one from March 63, a great two-sided record. And Chuck doesn't like styrene like I do, because unfortunately this is on a styrene record label, but it's still a great tune. These are the Delmonicos from March 63, the flip side of You Can Call on Aku Records. It's called There They Go. This is for Chuck. With a hiss.
Comes a vibe.
March 63 release for the Delmonicos. That one there going out to Chuck Mitchell. In our YouTube chat room, Aku Records, There They Go is the name of the tune. They also backed up Denise Germain with an Aku release. Teenage Idol, I think, was the song. I have that 45, I do, in my collection. We are in 1963. Here's a request for Adrian listening in Mexico. This group, though, is out of Long Island, New York. This is not an easy record to find. I think this group included Frank Mancuso. Now, he was also the lead singer of the Imaginations that recorded on Music Makers. Might be him on lead with on this side. This is on the Row label, R-O-W-E Records, which is out of Trenton, New Jersey. And this is actually a cover tune. They're doing the cover of a tune originally done by the Drifters, but this is going out to Adrian. These are the Cordon, C-O-R-D-O-N apostrophe S, from 1963 on the Row record label with their rendition of the tune, Some Kinda Wonderful. This is for Adrian.
All you have to do is touch my hand and show me you understand. And something happens to me that's some kind of wonderful. Anytime my little world seems blue, I just have to look at you and everything seems to be some kind of wonderful. I know I can't express this feeling of tenderness. There's so much I wanna say, but the right words won't come my way. I only know when I'm in your embrace, this world is a happy place. And everything seems to be some kind of wonderful. And I just want to tell you one thing, little girl. When days are dark and all things seems as though they're about to come to an end, darling, I can search my very soul, darling, and find a fire that I've never felt before. I realize that I'm just a shy guy, little girl, and I can't tell you all of the things that I really want to tell you. But I know that deep down in my heart, I love you so very, very much. And I want you to know, baby, I know I can't express this feeling of tenderness. There's so much I want to say, but the right words won't come my way. World is a happy place, and everything seems to be some kind of wonderful.
Cover tunes here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. That one there going out to Adrian, listening in Mexico. Adrian, you got to tell your friends, they don't know what they're missing with this music. That's a rare 45, too. I think I paid $300, $250 or $300 for that record. The Cordons from 1963, doing the Drifters tune, Some Kind of Wonderful, requested by Adrian on the Row record label. We stay in 1963 with a request for Kenny Mack as we go to Philadelphia, PA, with this group, with this 45. 1965 on the Gaiden record label, as the group was called Ernie and the Halos. Now, the lead singer on this is Ernie Spano. Ernie Spano, he was originally from the Fabulous Four that recorded for the Chancer record label. He is the lead here. I think he also recorded with the Four Evers. But this one, written and arranged by Bob Finniz and produced by Joe Wizard, March 1963. This is for Kenny Mack in our YouTube chat room. Ernie and the Halos on the Gaiden label. It's called Darlin' Don't Make Me Cry.
How could you tell me it's all over? Just because of some other guy. Whoa. Thought you really cared, but now you tell me it's all over. How could you treat me so unfair? I loved you so much, more than anything in this whole wide world. And you promised you would never break my heart. And now you're telling me that we must part. Back in my arms, cause I still love you, darling. Help me dry the tears, they're rolling from my eyes. Darling, don't do it any longer. Come back to me, darling. Don't tell me it's all over. Please, darling.
As going out to Kenny Mack in our YouTube chat room, Ernie and the Halos with Ernie Spano on lead, March 1963, release on the Gaiden label, Darling, Don't Make Me Cry. Let's move into 1964 now with a request for listener Butch Ford, listening in Hawaii. He wanted to hear this 45 out of Los Angeles, California. Now, the writer credit on both sides of this 45, wait a minute. Both sides of the 45 says, what does it say? It says Mark Allen. Of course, I didn't write it in. I guess he might be the lead singer on this as Little Marcus, I guess. But it's from 1964. I thought this was more like 62, but what do I know? There you go. Little Marcus and the Devotions on the Gordy label. This is for Butch. Another rare 45. It's called I'll Always Remember, similar title to the Sharp Tones that I played earlier from 59. This is for Butch.
I'll always remember the night you said goodbye. Pop, pop, pop. The many little things you say.
Going out to Butch Ford there. I guess it's 1964 sound, although that record would never make it in 1964. Little Marcus and the Devotions is the name of the group, Daryl. It's on the Gordy label, G-O-R-D-I-E. Yes, Jimmy spelled that way. It's called I'll Always Remember. Yes, we always remember these tunes. Maybe you don't remember them because you never heard them before, but aren't they great? We got two more 45s to go before Johnny G signs off here and go downstairs and check on the parents here. And this is a request for Amnon. I don't know much about this group, but it's on Irving Slim Rose's Times Square record label, which was founded in March of 1961. Of course, Slim was the owner of the Times Square record shop, originally located in a, quote, hole-in-the-wall shop in the subway entrance on the west side of the Times Tower on Broadway and 42nd Street in New York City. I wish I went there. I did not. I can only see pictures of it, unfortunately. But he was in that. He wanted to make money from the start to promote the then-dying group sound in rock and roll music and group harmony music. And he was very successful in that as a result of record companies re-releasing lots of their old catalog. So he was able to do that. So that's a credit to him. It is. But this is the only release for this unknown group. Can't find anything on this group, but it's a request for listener Amnon, an old request. And this is released in December of 64. This is on the Times Square record label. It's by Donnie and the Styles. And the song is called Chapel of Love.
We have often wondered if our love is true. Now I want to prove it to you. We will have to find a place that's up above. The name of that place is the Chapel of Love.
Oh yes, we're going to the chapel.
Oh
yes, the Chapel of Love.
Wah, wah.
Chapel of Love.
There you go. That's by request for listener Amnon there from December 1964. That's on Slim Rose's Times Square record label out of New York City, Donnie and the Styles. Donnie and the Styles, the name of the group, a song entitled Chapel of Love. Maybe you thought it was about the Dixie Cups. No way. That is totally a different tune. Anyway, that's going to do it for Johnny G and the Vinyl Treasure Show. I want to thank you for joining Johnny G, listening to these cool 45s out of my collection. If you want to get in touch with me, you can send me an email at vinyltreasures@aol.com. If you missed any of the show, at least on YouTube, you will be able to see, you'll see it. It'll post momentarily, as long as I don't get any copyright police strikes. That's the only thing. So it will be there. You can also go to my website, vinyltreasures.net. You can stream or download the show there. I've been posting the show there, so I know a lot of people go there to do that. So that is available also. And we are streaming live on Oldies and More Radio. We do that beginning at midnight, and we went into about 36 minutes. We're going to go for another, two or three minutes more of overtime here. Johnny G is beat. And really, though, it's really, I enjoy myself doing this. If you don't know or can't tell, do it every Saturday night. So thank you all for tuning in. Again, if you're new to the program, I ask you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And also, if you view the show during the week, if you can also click the thumbs up button. It's very important for that, as YouTube is keeping tabs on that for me as I'm trying to broaden the show. I don't have time to go and make a couple of snippet things, which I want to do. I just don't have the time yet, but I plan on doing that and much more. So thank you all again for tuning in tonight. I hope you heard some cool tunes tonight, maybe for the first time, or have seen some records that you never seen before. That is my aim, but basically to have a lot of fun like I do, to enjoy the music. That is the main thing of the show. It's a labor of love for me. Thank you, Charlene, for your help again. And really, that's going to do it. I'll be back next Saturday night at 9 Eastern Time, 9 till midnight. And I'll be back this coming Wednesday night. I'm getting my stitches removed, but I should be okay. No issues there. I can still talk. But I'll do the All 60s show. I play lots of Soul 45s on that Wednesday night show that streams simultaneously on Oldies and More Radio. So you can listen to Oldies and More Radio on their website, or you can come right here on YouTube and view Johnny G. But that's going to do it for tonight. We have a closer, though, as it is our final request tonight for listener Jim Sufaint. If I said your name right, if I said it wrong, I apologize, Jim. But this group is out of Long Island, New York, and it's their only release. It came out on the Stork record label. This tune co-written and produced by Ron Winters. In 1965, this group would change their name to the Four Directions and record for the Coral label. But prior to that, they had this release on the Stork label, and the lead singer on this is Tony Pesto. He's the lead, and maybe they were listening to a Caprice song to give them inspiration for this tune. But our closer tonight is from September 64 on Stork Records, going out to Jim Sufaint. These are the Themes, and their tune called There's No Moon, No Moon Tonight. Sort of an answer to the Caprice, There's a Moon Out Tonight. I don't know if there's a moon out tonight, but I can tell you probably not, because it's 24 degrees and mostly cloudy here. That's a heat wave, because we got down to 1 degree here in Westchester County in New York. But anyway, thank you all again for tuning in, and I hope to see you next Saturday night right here. Tell your friends about it. Everybody have a safe and happy week. Just want to say, everybody, so long.